January is almost over. How are your New Year's resolutions going? Honestly, I didn't include a diet on my resolutions list, but a lot of people did. Actually, almost 3/4 of all New Year's resolution lists include some kind of a diet. Crazy, right? Well, considering we live in a superficial world, not really. Okay, but we don't just want to look good, we also want to be healthy. But do diets and health really fit together? How healthy are diets? Every year, the BDA publishes the list of 5 worst celeb diets of the past year. You know, those that we should definitely avoid. And before we take a look at them, let me warn you. Some of them are really ridiculous, while some of them are actually dangerous. People are more interested than ever in fitness, nutrition, and health, which is amazing. But this also means good business for many quacks out there, and this is why it's important to do proper research before starting another new diet. And keep in mind that if it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. Now, here we go. 5 diets that we should definitely not try in 2019. The blood type diets. The blood type diet is not new, but it had quite a hype in 2018. This diet claims that you can only eat certain kinds of food depending on your blood type. That is supposedly because a person's blood type determines how the food will be broken down in the body. And that is total nonsense according to the BDA. Blood type A eating vegan while blood type O eating mostly protein is a bad idea, because cutting out food groups completely often leads to some kind of deficiency. Unless your doctor or dietitian plans it with you. But the question you might be asking yourself is, how come this diet works even if it's bollocks? Because I've personally seen people lose weight on this diet. It is true, people do lose weight. But that is not because of the magical diet. It's because any kind of diet where you restrict your calories and eat less processed foods will make you lose weight. And next up we have urine therapy. This is just a fancy word for drinking your own pee. Some advocates of this diet claim that it is boosting your immune system, is very energizing and cleansing. Well, the BDA is against it. They say there is no evidence or advice which would encourage anybody to drink their own waste. And guess what? There is actually a good reason why it's called waste. Urine is our body's way to eliminate toxins from our system. So why would you reabsorb toxins your body already got rid of? Therefore, urine therapy can potentially be harmful and put us in risk of infection. And let's not even talk about how gross this is. Okay. Next! Detox teas and skinny coffee. Another magic potion that we often see on social media. Kim Kardashian and a bunch of bloggers and influencers might claim they look amazing thanks to a certain kind of drink. But that's a lie. It all comes down to marketing. We all want to look great without doing much. But the pure logic can tell us that just drinking something while eating very unhealthy is not gonna make us look like models. These drinks often contain a lot of laxatives, which can lead to diarrhea and stomach cramps. Others are high in caffeine, and drinking a lot of them means shaky hands, heart pumping, and anxiety. Both can be dangerous for our health. So if losing weight by having diarrhea is something you were gonna have fun with, then this is the diet for you. If not, moving on. Slimming sachets. 2018 was the year of the big wedding, and Prince Harry was getting in shape using a supplement called Slim Me. This powder is supposed to suppress hunger, improve your metabolism, and detox your body. And you have to take it 3 times a day. And have I mentioned that it costs £100 a month? At least your wallet is for sure gonna be slimming down. According to the BDA, these kinds of sachets are nothing but a good marketing move. And while some people do indeed lose weight, the change is not permanent. As soon as you no longer want to spend £100 a month, your weight will come back and you might even gain some. Any slimming supplements are unnecessary and in some cases even harmful. For the majority of people, changing to a healthier, balanced diet will provide all the essential vitamins and minerals that our metabolism needs to work properly. We don't need any additional supplements. Last but not least, we have alkaline water. Another drink. Man, do we really think that just by drinking something we can change how we look? Alkaline water contains alkalizing compounds, and because of that, some believe it helps our bodies metabolize nutrients and get rid of toxins more efficiently compared to tap water, which could promote better health. But it's not so. Yes, drinking more water is a good thing, a great thing, but there is no reason for us to buy expensive alkaline water when we have perfectly good and cheap water running right out of our taps. The alkaline diet was on last year's list of worst diets, alkaline water on this year's. Why? Simply because both of these diets are based on a misunderstanding of human physiology. We think that what we eat directly impacts the pH of our blood. But that is false. Our body does these regulations itself. If it doesn't do it, no water will help us. We will get very ill very fast. So, besides paying a lot for alkaline water, we are often paying for nothing, as regular water's pH is 7, while some alkaline waters the BDA tested had pH of 7.0 or 7.5 at a push. The bottom line is that losing weight is simple, at least in theory. We have to consume less calories than we burn. This can mean we do more exercise or eat fewer calories, or possibly both. Magical diets that are highly restrictive are the main reason for the boomerang effect. We lose weight and then we get it back as soon as we start eating normally. So the perfect diet is the diet you can keep up forever. This means it's not high maintenance and it's not very restrictive. Adding in some physical activity and you get to keep your beach-ready body all year long. Because you know the beach is still there even if we're wearing a lot of clothes. And that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. Tell me, do you agree? Have you tried any of these diets? Let me know in the comments. Like the video and share it. And don't forget to subscribe to not miss our next video. See you then. Bye bye.